Hey guys, I'm Kent and you're watching DiaGraphics. Today I want to show you how to create this coin inside Adobe Illustrator. So the first thing you want to do is go to View, then go to Show Grid, then go to View again and Snap to Grid. Then you want to select the Ellipse tool and draw a circle that is 3x3 squares. Hold down the Shift key to get a perfect circle. Now we want to get rid of the border, so click the border and click None. Then select the Fill and go to Swatches. And I have prepared some swatches for this project that you can download down in the description. To load these swatches, you want to go to this menu, go to Open Swatch Library, Other Libraries, and select the swatches where you have them on your computer, like this. Then click the folder to add them to your swatch menu. So now choose the light gold color. Then go to the selection tool, and while having the circle selected, you want to hold down the Alt key or Option key on Mac to duplicate and click the down arrow key one time, like this. Then right click, go to Arrange and Send to Back. Then select the dark gold color for this one. This will make the shadow down here. Now zoom in a little bit and select both circles, and now we need to connect these two anchor points. It's not that important on this coin, but if you have one that is thicker, you will have a gap right here, as you can see if I do this. Right here is a gap. So for the sake of this video, I will close it. So you want to take the rectangle tool, draw a rectangle between these two points and all the way over here. Then you want to right click this, arrange and send to back. Now the gap is closed. Now zoom out, go to the selection tool, select the front of the coin, go to object, path, offset path, and select minus 20 pixels. This will make a smaller circle that is offset by minus 20 pixels all the way around. Select the stroke and make the stroke the dark color. Make the stroke 4 points thick. Now close the swatches and hold down the Alt key to duplicate. Drag the circle. And before you release, hold down the Shift key too to align it and release it over here. Now once again, while having the circle selected, hold down the Alt key or the Option key on Mac and click the down arrow key one time. Then release Option or Alt and click the down arrow key one more time. Then select both of these circles, remove the border, go to the Pathfinder tool. If you don't have the Pathfinder tool right here, you can find it up in the Windows here. Now click minus front up here to get this kind of shape. Now select the fill, go to swatches and select the dark brown color. Now click the shape, hold down the shift key and drag it over here until it snaps, like this. Now select the big circle. Close down the swatches to get some space. Duplicate this as well by holding down the Alt key and drag it over here. Now duplicate this one and drag it up so the middle of the circle intersects with the top of the old circle, like this. Then select both the circles, go to swatches and select the white color. Then go down to Pathfinder and select intersect right here. Then give this an opacity that is 50%. Then again, drag this over while holding shift until it aligns and snaps, like this. And now you have the coin. So now we just need to put in the currency you want. So select the text tool, and I would like a cent symbol. So the Alt code for this is hold down Alt and click 0162. Then select it and make it 130 points. And choose the type that you want. Now make this symbol the dark gold color, right here. Go to the selection tool, right click the symbol and go to create outlines. Then drag it to the middle. To align it to the middle, you want to select the symbol and hold down the shift key to select the circle too. Then go to this menu and click Align to Key Object. Make sure that the circle is the key object. This will make sure that the circle stays in place and the symbol is moving to the middle. So now, click this button to align it vertical and click this button to align it horizontal. And as you can see, this is the exact middle, but it doesn't look like the middle. So to get the optical middle, you can just adjust it as you want. That looks better. The last thing you want to do is select the entire coin, go to Transform, and make sure Scale Strokes and Effect are on. This will make sure that when you scale the coin, the strokes are scaling too. So this is how to create a coin inside Adobe Illustrator. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up or subscribe to my channel if you want to see more of these graphic design tutorials. Thank you for watching.